But it is here, right here in front of us. And so we thank God for all that is taking place here and around the world. And we want God to know that we are still his people. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you that. That's why it's important that we are here. As Muslims, as Jews, as Christians, and everything else that you think you might be. Because we need people of faith that will step out by faith and pray to God so that God would heal all of our wounds and to bring us where we need to be. We don't need to be quiet about anything because we're sickened and appalled by the inhumanity that we have witnessed in the recent deaths at the hand of police officers. Say my name, Breonna Taylor. Say my name, George Floyd. Say my name, Ahmaud Arbery. We call for the repeal of Legislative Action 58. We stand with Councilman Member Wingo, Crystal People Stokes, and for all of those that are standing on the side of justice. We stand with the National Action Network and Reverend Al. As he eulogized Brother Floyd, he told him that this country has got to get its knee over our neck. And we have got to stand up and be the change that we're calling for. Thank God for a city of brotherly love. I don't know about you, but I feel better today. Why? Because the man came down from his illustrious executive office and came out in the middle of Martin Luther King Park. And the executive officer, the chief executive officer, lifted up a word of prayer. If ever we're going to make it, we need somebody in high places to pray for us. So I thank God for a praying mayor, one that knows the word of God and can lead us on in the right place. So I said, Father, I stretch. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and let us not forget all the benefits that have come from all of the things that have happened to us. Everything happens for a reason. This is a watershed moment. We're standing up. We're making a difference. Just the people here today are going to make a difference in the communities that you go back to. That we will not be the same. We will not accept the status quo. We need a change, and we need a change right now in order for us to be who God is calling for. For all of those that have died in an unjust act, say their name. For everybody that's been abused, say their name. Everybody that died in the holding center, say their name. For everybody that's afflicted right now, say your own name. And pray that God will make a way out of no way. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace.
From the National Action Network, he is our president for the Niagara Falls and Buffalo area. Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to ask Minister Kenny Simmons to lead us in prayer. Pastor Kenny Simmons, to lead us in prayer.
Let's go, Kenny.
Come on, somebody say praise the Lord. Come on, all y'all say praise the Lord. To my mother and brothers, I greet you, assalamu alaikum. To my Jewish brothers, I greet you, shalom. To my Christian brothers and sisters, I greet you, God's peace and good journey. The 133rd division of Psalm says this in the first verse. Behold how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. That word behold in the Hebrew means take notice. It means pay attention. And I need for everybody to look around and pay attention to what's taking place right now. Pay attention to who's standing by you. Pay attention to all the fraternities and sororities and locals and unions that's out here right now. Pay attention to the politicians and to the pastors and the community leaders and the activists that's out here right now. The Bible says, behold, pay attention and take notice how good and pleasant it is that we are all standing in Martin Luther King Park. A symbolism of peace in our community. Take notice. Pay attention to what's going on. He said, behold how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. This is a pleasant moment, for this is the city of good neighbors. This is the city of brotherly love. Amen. And we are all standing here in this pleasant and precious moment. This is a precious moment in the eyesight of God. And the reason why it's precious, because there's unity amongst the people. There's unity amongst the Jews. There's unity amongst the Muslims. There's unity amongst the Christians. There's unity amongst the atheists. There's unity amongst the non-believers. So we want to give God a round of applause. And God, thank you for the unity that's in this circle right now. Thank you for the vision of Pastor Tim Newkirk. Thank you for the vision of our mayor. Together we stand, divided we fall. Say that with me. Together we stand, divided we fall. Come on, together we stand, divided we fall. Together we stand, divided we fall. So together in unity, let's just pray the Lord's Prayer, and I'm going to take my seat. Let us bow our heads. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive. As we forgive, come on somebody, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, thine is the power, thine is the glory, forever and ever. To God be the glory. Assalamu alaikum, shalom. God's peace and good journey.
Listen, Lord. Right now we're going to have our friend, our brother, the Honorable Reverend. Oh, I'm sorry, not Reverend. Richard Lipsick, who is the president of the Western New York Area Labor Federation. He's going to come at this time.
Dear brothers and sisters, racism is a dagger in the heart of working class unity. If we are ever to achieve our goals of economic and social justice for all working people, we must stand shoulder to shoulder in the fight to stop police brutality and the murder of the African American people, once and for all. Black lives do matter. Today's event has been called to reflect and to unify. As a time to pause and look into each other's eyes and to know each other as friend, as ally, as brother and sister. It is only as we stand together as one force that we create a mighty torrent that says no to the abomination of racist violence. It is only through this struggle that we can begin to heal as a country. I must say one more thing. We must play our part in removing the chief hate monger, Donald Trump, and all his enablers from power. Brothers and sisters, this is the task that must be taken up for solution. Now, with that, I have a very great honor. I'm proud to introduce my dear friend and brother in struggle, Terry Melvin, president of the National Coalition of Black Trade Unionists and secretary treasurer of the New York State AFL-CIO. Terry?
Eric Gardner, Michael Brown Jr., Tamir Rice, Brianna
Taylor. Ahmaud Arbery. George Floyd. Before I can say anything before you today, I would be remiss if I did not call out the names, a few names, of those who brought us here today. But I want to tell you on behalf of the state labor movement, on behalf of the federal labor movement, we stand with Black Lives Matter. So many out there are trying to take this opportunity to tell working men and women that they should be against their unions because of a few rogue people out there, a few rogue leaders out there. But let me be clear, we stand with you today, tomorrow, and until victory is won. You have to understand what we are dealing with. It's not just Breonna, Ahmaud, and Floyd. It is not just the murder of them. What we're dealing